good to me. What I began to understand more and more, the more I walk with the Lord, I begin to understand one thing, that suffering you can't get around. That if you are in this world, you will suffer. And don't mess around and confess Christ. You then have opened up the door for suffering to come in. And if the truth be told, from the pulpit to the back door, nobody likes to suffer. Everybody wants every day to be sunshine. But I come to find out too much sun makes a desert. Without some rain, there wouldn't be any watermelons or cantaloupes. There wouldn't be any green trees or shade. So rain comes with suffering. And if you haven't had any showers lately in your life, don't get too happy. Don't get to turning flips. It's just not your season of going through. But if, like my grandmama said, if you keep a living, trouble will find you, even when you don't want to be found. There are so many different avenues of suffering. Suffering in the mind, suffering in the body, suffering financially, suffering in relationships, and all of them are uncomfortable. But I come to discover that suffering really shows what type of character you have. Because if you can, if you talk about more about your suffering than you do about your Savior, then we have a big problem. Because there's nothing about suffering that Christ himself has not already suffered. All of his afflictions, all of his adversities, the enemies that Christ had, Christ suffered. And if Christ suffered, and you have one day planned that when I leave this place, that I'm going to heaven to be with my Savior, you have to remember the only way to get there is, he says, that if you suffer with me. Y'all, come on, y'all know the Bible. If you suffer with me, you will reign with me. Here's the thing. Most folk that suffer, most folk that go through fall into a state of depression. They fall into a state as if God cannot handle what it is you're having to endure. Can I bless you real good? The reason I pulled this text, the reason this text is such a burden on my heart to talk to you this morning, if you think about the suffering that you're suffering now, don't even worry about it. If you would just take a step back and look at your life, look at what God has done, how God has bought you, how he has kept you, how he has delivered you, even when you didn't know what was going to happen, you'll find out God has done too much in my past for me not to trust him in my present. And how soon we forget. Is there anybody in here that has been in a situation and you didn't know how you were going to come out, that you thought you was going to lose your mind, and just when you was on the brink of giving up, God stepped in and he turned your situation around. He gave you peace in your mind. He gave you joy back. And if God did it then, he's the same God. And if you allow him, he'll turn this situation around. He'll make your day brighter and your burden lighter. Isaiah is one of the most interesting books. Before, when they were breaking the Bible down and talking about what books go in, what books come out, Isaiah originally was in three different books. There's the first Isaiah, second Isaiah, third Isaiah. When they broke the books down and began to put the Bible together, they made Isaiah all one book. He called a major prophet because most of his writings are long. You'll see how he has one of the longest Bibles out of the major and the minor prophets. One thing Isaiah does that only a few other prophets do here, they talk about Jesus. Okay, y'all missed it. Isaiah talks about Jesus before Jesus is ever born. He calls him Emmanuel. He talks about the suffering of Jesus. He talks about how he was wounded for our transgressions, that he was bruised for our iniquity, and the chastisement of our peace was upon him. And with his stripes, we are healed.